شكرا يا ربي شكرا هديت قلبي شكرا.
Ramadan is a blessed month, it's upon us, and you know the virtues of Ramadan are obviously just amazing. You know, everything that you do in this month is multiplied. Everything that we do is more rewarding. Then there's that night, which is better than khayrun min alf shahr, 1,000 months of worship, Laylatul Qadr. The first awaluha, you know, the first 10 days is rahma, awsatuha maghfira, the second 10 days is maghfira, and the last 10 days is itqu raqabati min an-nar. The last 10 days are, you know, the souls will be freed from Jahannam, and they'll be entered into Jannah, inshallah. So this is that month where we harvest, we reap, we take as much as we can, we really take benefit. Everything's on sale. You know how we go crazy on Black Friday and, you know, Boxing Day and this day and that day. In this month of Ramadan, all the actions are on sale. They're on sale. And if we don't make the most of it, then we are the ones to blame. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man sama Ramadana imanan wa ihtisaba, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi." The person who fasts in the month of Ramadan, imanan wa ihtisaba, he has iman, in the state of iman, and he's fasting while he's aware that there is a reward for this, and he hopes in the return from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِ. And verily, this person's sins will be forgiven. And also forgiven, don't forget, in this month, you know, the sunnah of Taraweeh is upon us as well. And this year, unfortunately, we won't be able to go to the masjid. The masajid are locked. You know, all those times the masjid was open, we were not maybe paying attention and maybe not so mindful, and today we lost the opportunity to go to the masjid. But this is that chance to make our homes into masjid. This is that chance where we can bring masjid into our homes. This is that chance where we can bring divine help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, divine rahmat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala into our homes by establishing the actions that we would usually perform in the masjid, starting with salah, recitation of Quran. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن. That this month, this is the month of Quran. This is the month where the Quran was revealed. إِنَّا أَنزَلْنَاهُ فِي لَيْلَةِ الْقَدْرِ. Verily, in this month, in the night of Qadr, in the night of this majestic night, the Quran was revealed. So my respected brothers and elders, and my dear respected sisters, this is the night where we have to, this is the month where we have to really make most of it. And what better than to be locked up in our own homes, forced to be in some type of itikaf, where we are restricted from going outside, we're restricted to our homes. What better chance and opportunity are we going to get to make most out of Ramadan than this Ramadan? Let's make an intention that this Ramadan is going to be the best Ramadan. Rasulullah says, if the people knew what this month of Ramadan represented, they would have wished the whole year would be Ramadan. They would wish that the whole year would be Ramadan. So this is that month where, like I said, everything is on display just for me and you to grab. Let's make the most of it, inshallah. You know, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he says that لِصَائِمِ فَرْحَتَانِ, that the first thing, fasting person, there's two happy times. One occasion is that when he, عِنْدَ فِطْرِهِ, when he breaks his fast and he does iftar. And the other one is عِنْدَ لِقَاءِ رَبِّهِ, when he meets his Allah. You know, Rasulullah Allah also says, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that كُلُّ عَمَلْ إِبْنَ آدَمْ لَهُ, all the actions of Bani Adam is for him, إِلَّا الصَّوْمِ, except for this fasting. This as-sawm li, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, that his sawm, this fasting, he does it for me. Nobody's watching him, yet he doesn't take a sip of water, yet he doesn't put a morsel of food in his mouth. He does so fearing me, knowing me, loving me, knowing that I'm watching him. Nobody, he can easily cheat and take a sip, just like I'm doing right now. You don't know, but I'm taking a sip of my drink right now as we speak. Yet, nobody can catch you. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, just out of the fear of Allah, out of the love of Allah, that you keep that fast and you don't eat, and you abstain from eating and drinking, you abstain from conjugal relationships, then this becomes so beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, As-sawmu li wa ana ajizi bihi, that this sawm, this fasting is for me, and I myself shall reward the fasting people. Allah Himself will reward the fasting people. This is for Allah and Allah Himself. In another narration, wa ana ujza bihi, that I myself is the reward for the fasting people. Oh dear Muslims, oh my Muslim brothers and sisters, what else do we need if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Himself is the reward for the fasting people, is the reward for us fasting, that we get the nearness of Allah, we get the love and affection of Allah, we get Allah. What else do we need, my brothers and sisters? What else do we need? Just reading this, just saying this is making me happy. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us, you know, among those who gets this month. You know that hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he stepped on the minbar. On first step he said Ameen, second step he said Ameen, third step he said Ameen. Sahaba asked, Ya Rasulullah, we have not seen you do this before. This is, what was this about? He said, Jibreel came to me, I mean, he made dua every single step, and I said Ameen. One of those dua was that the person is, you know, he's such a, you know, he has lost, and he's among the loser, and he's basically, he has done no good, is that he got the month of Ramadan, and the Ramadan came and Ramadan went, and he was not forgiven. May we be among those people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the forgiveness. He forgives us during this blessed month. He accepts us during this blessed month. Having said that, in the month of Ramadan, there's many fiqh, and there are many jurisprudence, rules and regulations. How does the fast break? What are the intentions? And when does it start? When does it finish? What is the kafara? What is fidya? What is qada? What is this? What is that? There's many things regarding fast, the fiqh of fasting. So inshallah, tomorrow we will take the time to speak about the fiqh of fasting, inshallah. So just to recap, we will continue Hayatul Sahaba, inshallah, every day during Ramadan. Just like we will continue Hayatul Sahaba during Ramadan as well. If not, this session will continue. Maybe we'll discuss something else. Maybe we will do tafsir of the Quran. I'm not sure yet what we're going to do, but this session will continue. The time will change, however. The time will change from the afternoon. From the evening, it will be in the afternoon, inshallah. So the time will change. If it's Ramadan from tomorrow, then from tomorrow at 2 p.m. after Dhuhr Salah, at 2 p.m. inshallah, we will have our program. And tomorrow at 2 p.m. we'll do the fiqh of Salah. We'll do the fiqh of Ramadan, fiqh of fasting, fiqh of Sawm, inshallah. Tomorrow at 2 p.m. onwards, we'll have the session, this session of contemplation from isolation, instead of having it at 8:30 at night, we're going to have it at 2 p.m. inshallah, after Dhuhr Salah, every day during Ramadan, inshallah. I hope everybody will be tuning in. Especially tomorrow, please let your friends and family members know. It's very important that Ramadan comes once a year. We might forget the fiqh of Ramadan, we might forget the Masla Masail, we might forget what breaks the fast, you know, we might have questions. So inshallah, hopefully this little info session will answer our questions, inshallah, and will refresh our memories, inshallah. So please, for tomorrow, remember that we'll have this this session, inshallah, at 2 p.m. inshallah, 2 p.m. And so that's that. And inshallah, if you brothers and sisters have any suggestions that during Ramadan what we should talk about, please do let me know, reach out to me and let me know, inshallah. And maybe we will put Hayatul Sahaba on pause, and we will maybe discuss other things, or we might have two different sessions. We'll continue Hayatul Sahaba, and we'll maybe do something else, tafsir, or you know, whatever topic you might want to talk about, inshallah. In the month of Ramadan, I think we should do tafsir, because this is the month of Quran, and we should understand the Quran in this month. So what better way to do that in the month of Ramadan, inshallah. So again, like I said, if tomorrow is Ramadan, then we'll have the session at 2, And regardless if tomorrow is Ramadan or not, tomorrow at 2 we're going to have a fiqh of Saum, fiqh of Ramadan. Tomorrow at 2 we'll have fiqh of Ramadan on this very channel, inshallah. Please share it with your friends and family, inshallah. And I will send out a reminder also tomorrow, inshallah. Jazakumullah khairan. Subhanallah bihamdihi. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Ya man la tarahu al-uyun wa la tukhalituhu al-dhunun wa la yasifu al-wasifun wa la tughayyiru al-hawadis wa la yakhsha al-dawair. Ya man ya'lamu mathaqil al-jibal wa makail al-bihar wa adada qatl al-amtar wa adada waraq al-ashjar wa adada ma azlama alayhi al-layl wa ashraqa alayhi al-nahar wa la tuwari minha sama'un sama'a wa la ardun arda wa la jabalun ma fi wa'li wa la bahrun ma fi qa'li. Ij'al khayra amrina akhira wa khayra amalina fawatima wa khayra ayyamina yawma nalqaka fihi. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. رب اغفر وارحم وتجاوز عما تعلم إنك أنت العزيز الأكرم. اللهم اهدنا واهد بنا واجعلنا سببا لمن اهتدى. يا مقلب القلوب ثبت قلوبنا على دينك ويا مصرف القلوب صرف قلوبنا إلى طاعتك. اللهم إنا نواصينا وجوارحنا بيديك لم تملكنا منها شيئا وإذا فعلت ذلك بنا فكن أنت ولينا واهدنا إلى سواء السبيل. Ya Allah, forgive our sins, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, the month of Ramadan is upon us, Ya Allah. Whether tonight or tomorrow, Ya Allah, we'll start, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, Ya Rahman Rahimin, forgive our sins before the month of Ramadan. Ya Allah, Ya Rahman Rahimin, make us, enable us to make the most out of this month, Ya Allah. Utilize this month to the fullest, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, let us revive the amal of the masjid, the actions of the masjid, those good deeds of the masjid in our homes, Ya Allah. Let us turn our homes into masjid, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, Ya Rahman Rahimin, all the brothers and sisters that are all around the world making effort, Ya Allah. Accept them, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, all the brothers and sisters that are sick, Ya Allah, give them cure, Ya Allah. All the brothers and sisters that have passed away, Ya Allah, forgive them. And Ya Allah, give them Jannah of Firdaus, Ya Allah. Those brothers and sisters who are not blessed with Iman, Ya Allah, especially our government and our fellow Canadians, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, we love them. Ya Allah, we care about them. They're great people, Ya Allah. Give them Hidayah. Give them the best gift of Iman, Ya Allah. Ya Allah, Ya Rahmin, you are indeed in control of everything, Ya Allah. Please, Ya Allah, forgive us and accept us, Ya Allah. Subhanallah. ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين. جزاكم الله خيرا. Those of you who are still online, as of now we still don't have any confirmation, so all the east coast provinces and states have negative moon sightings so far, and we are now waiting for the Pacific, so the other side, the west side, to give us some kind of confirmation of moon sighting. So as of now, there's no moon sighting yet. So inshallah, stay tuned, you know, stay in touch with your local imam, local masjid, and hopefully inshallah we'll have news for whether or not we have to pray tarawih tonight, inshallah. Jazakumullah khairan. Until tomorrow, remember, 2 p.m. tomorrow, we have fiqh of Ramadan. So please tune in at 2 tomorrow, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.